In President Noynoy Aquino's inaugural address, he gave his marching orders to the new Justice Secretary to begin the process of providing true and complete justice for all. Tonight, we talk to former Commission on Human Rights Chairperson and now Justice Secretary Leila de Lima. Good evening to you, Secretary.
Yes, good evening, Ces, and good evening to your televiewers.
Thank you for making the time. We know you're one of the busiest secretaries.
Yes, definitely. Well, remember, it's supposed to be last week.
Yes.
It was reset.
Right. Okay. Well, the president, time and time again in his campaign, would talk about the low conviction rate and the length of time it takes to adjudicate a case. 7 years, I think, is the average time. Mm-hmm. So, what are your plans to reduce the time and to increase the conviction rate?
Okay, so first of all, yes, we confirm that, you know, the justice sector reform is really a highlight and a priority thrust of the new administration. Very, very important. It's in fact the centerpiece, I think, to make sure that the criminal justice system works. Now, you're right, the president has been saying that we need improvement on the very, very meek conviction rate of 18%. Now, what are we supposed to do that? How do we plan to do it? Now, of course, we need to motivate our prosecutors, train them more, and hire more prosecutors. There is a high vacancy rate in just like in the judiciary, in the prosecution service also, because the ideal ratio is two prosecutors for one sala. Now, what the prosecutors now are doing is they handle multi-sala. You know, one prosecutor for several branches of the court. So they become overworked, and when people become overworked, they become less motivated. So in those areas, and of course, the recruitment of new prosecutors should be based on meritocracy, based on merit and fitness, so that you would have really the right people, competent and driven workers.
How many do you intend to hire?
Well, I'm reviewing the plantilla because I need to correlate it really to the number of courts.
Okay. So there may be thousands. Well, any rough estimate?
Maybe more than 1,000.
I hope you'll be supported by the budget in this. Well, if the president says this is the centerpiece of his government, then...
As a matter of fact, the proposed budget for 2011 is 151% over and above, the 151% higher than the last one. And much of it would really go to the hiring and training of prosecutors.
But you will have to work closely as well with the Supreme Court here, the judiciary on that.
Yes, definitely. Well, you see the pillars of the justice system. I think the DOJ handles about three or four of the pillars of the justice system. You have, of course, the investigation, the prosecution, and then the legal assistance and the correctional or rehabilitation. Now, of course, the courts. The courts would have the final say. The courts would render judgment. But before the courts can truly and effectively perform also its function, then we have to present the right evidence. So we need good prosecutors to make up good and strong cases in court. So we will work closely with the Supreme Court, especially in the areas of improving access to justice, especially of the poor, the underprivileged.
Well, those who are closely watching your taking over the helm of the Justice Department want you to prioritize the extrajudicial killings and media killings as well.
Yes.
So in the past, they created an ad hoc committee.
Task force.
A task force. Yes. So there are, what is your approach?
Oh, yes. I'm also reviewing the various task forces. There are several. There is Task Force USIG. There's Task Force 211. There is also a separate DOJ task force, all dealing with political killings or extra-legal killings, as well as media killings. Now, I'm reviewing them because I would, you know, we need to avoid overlapping of functions. And I think it's time to really create a multi-sectoral body to address seriously. Mm. Both extrajudicial killings or political killings and media killings, especially that we now see again a resurgence, which is very disheartening. First few days of the new administration, and here we are. Why are this happening? So again, because of the impunity. There is culture of impunity because there has not been enough convictions during the last administration. So we have to really work doubly hard to address.
Were the previous task forces not multi-sectoral? They were only involving law enforcement and prosecution.
Yes, just prosecutors and assisted.
Sorry. When you mean multi-sectoral, who do you mean? NGOs,
We will. We can involve NGOs. So aside from government agencies, part of the executive department, like DOJ, NBI, PNP, and maybe DILG, then we need to invite also various NGOs. Now, for example, in the media killings, we can involve various media organizations like NUJP for their input so that they can closely monitor. And of course, the CHR will be involved maybe as an advisor because it's an independent constitutional body. Now, DOJ can spearhead, you know, this we want it to be really an umbrella thing. Maybe we can, because I will review the composition of all these task forces. And I can utilize some same people, depending on their performance, and also because you know.
Also, if they've been following up the cases for a long period of time already.
Yes, because we need to start, I think, with the current ones, and then we can go back. The current ones more focused, so that we can achieve successful prosecution and conviction.
So when is your target to reorganize or name people to the task force or body that would go and do the investigation?
Well, we want it to be within the next few weeks, or if not before the SONA, right after the SONA, because the priority now is the creation of the task, the Truth Commission, to address the graft cases. So we would want to target it before SONA. I'm just really actually waiting for the draft executive order from the office of the executive secretary. I'm sure that they will refer that to me for my own inputs. And then, but while waiting for that, I have already assigned certain prosecutors to also start crafting the executive order relative to the media killings.
I see. So that will be also be covered by an executive order.
Yeah, I would propose to the president to also issue an executive order, because I think the task force USIG was created by an administrative order, and then the task force 211, another issuance. So it's got to be an executive order.
What's